Hey everybody, and welcome to Eurogamer. My name's Ian Higton, and I'm going to be taking you through Metal Gear Rising Revengeance today. I'm going to be playing about an hour's worth, spoiler warning, it's going to be the first hour of the game. I can hear myself, so that's all good. That means you can hear me too. It's going to be the first hour of the game. There will be spoilers, so if you're waiting for the game to be released or in the UK, which is on Friday the 22nd, then please do turn off now. If you've got the game, if you're in America, where it's been released today, and you haven't played it yet and you want it all to be fresh, turn off now. This is it's going to be the first hour, so there will be spoilers. With that bit out of the way, I'd quickly like to say follow me on Twitter here, Ian Higton, if you want more updates on Eurogamer's videos and live streams. Also follow Eurogamer on Twitter as well for all the big gaming news, all our reviews and like breaking news and stuff goes there. And we'll also be live tweeting tomorrow from the PlayStation event in New York. So you definitely want to follow that for all the instant details on what's going on regarding PlayStation's announcement. And you'll see all that written up as well on Eurogamer.net. And hopefully I'll be making some videos for it as well. I guess that's all I really got to say before I start playing Metal Gear Rising. So let me load the game up and get some graphics in. Matty Max is watching. He says hello. Hello, Matty Max. Got 24 people watching at the moment. Feel free to say hello if you want to shout out or anything. Let me know your thoughts on the game, whether you're going to buy it, whether you're going to wait and see how this plays out first. Maybe you really don't want to touch it. Who knows? It's Kojima Productions have produced it, but this obviously isn't made by Kojima Productions. It's developed by Platinum Games instead. It's published by Konami, and it's out on the Xbox 360 and the PS3, and it's released 22nd of the 2nd. That's the English way to write dates. A lot of people have said, Ian, you write your dates the wrong way around, but those people are obviously from America. 22nd of the 2nd is 22nd of February 2013. This Friday it's going to be out in the UK. I've played about a third of the game, and not being a massive brawler fan, as regular viewers might know, I've really enjoyed it. Recent games that I could compare it to would probably be Devil May Cry and Anarchy Reigns, and I've enjoyed it much more than both of them. FIFA Skills says, "Hello, Ian." Sean Palmer says, "Please chop up multiple melons." And by melons, I do mean heads. Namefighter says, "Hello." Chris Lloyd says, "Hi." We've got quite a few people watching now, and the numbers are building up. So hello to everyone who's joined. There we go. I'm going to start a brand new file. So we will be seeing the intro cinematic as well in a second. While that's running, I'll make myself disappear. Checking for downloaded content. So it's going to be some kind of downloaded stuff later on. Let's go story. New game. And as always with these types of games, I'm going to play easy because you don't want to see me die constantly for an hour. Easy assist mode to allow for automatic direction input when parrying. This is recommended for those who are both new to action games and want to play on a lower difficulty. That's me. So here we go. I can't be bothered to play the tutorial. The tutorial takes place in a VR training room. Anyway, here we go. I'll be quiet for 5. Let me know if the audio is okay, by the way. In just 3 short years.
The sign of a strong leader, sir.
No. The will of a strong people. And one very able advisor.
Thank you, sir.
Your team deserves credit as well. The lightning bolt.
Just doing our job, Mr. Prime Minister.
I must admit, I once thought of groups like yours as opportunists, enablers of war. But you've trained our new army well. Order has returned sooner than expected. Perhaps I was wrong about these private military companies.
We prefer private security providers, sir. Most of Maverick's contracts do focus on security.
Yes, well, the security can mean many things.
Apologies for that.
There's a saying I like.
Stupid antivirus.
One sword keeps another in the sheath. Sometimes the threat of violence alone is a deterrent. Sometimes by taking a life, others can be preserved. It's the code the samurai lived by.
A soldier and a philosopher. You are full of surprises, Mr. Lightning Bolt.
I could say the same about you, Mr. Prime Minister.
What is happening?
Someone's blocking a lead vehicle. Hold on.
Clear the road! This is official state business!
Stay calm.
He's got friends on our 12.
Raiden.
I'm on it. Guard the Prime Minister.
That a sailor? Nice high heels. Cool, so that was the long intro. I'll just read some questions out before we get going that popped up during this thing. Master Mantis says, was Ian too scared to play Slender after all then? No, my PC just couldn't run it while streaming at the same time. I wasn't too scared. I'm getting a new PC and I'll be back with Slender, don't worry. Internissus says, I generally find Eurogamer trustworthy regarding Platinum, so I was happy to see the high scoring review today. I'm pretty curious to see how the story turned out, since it isn't Kojima though. So, we awarded this game 9 out of 10. The link to the written review is down in the description of the video. If you want to go and read that, it was written by Rich Stanton, who is like Eurogamer's resident fighter brawler expert. He's like the guy with the skills, like he's like Obi-Wan to my, I don't know, C-3PO. He's really good, so, you know, his word is definitely to be trusted when talking about brawlers. So, yeah, so 9 out of 10 that was. Please do read it if you want some detailed insights into how it plays from the viewpoint of someone who actually plays these types of games a lot. How long did it take you to get used to controls the first time around? Read that unintuitive for some, says Namefinder. I found it quite easy. I'm playing on easy, so... there's a bit of assist, but parrying and stuff, you kind of press forward and X at the same time. And I picked it up pretty easy. I found it a lot of fun. Is this coming to the PC? Don't think so. How's the frame rate hold up, Ian, says Sean Palmer. Frame rate holds up fine. I never see any. It looks lovely and smooth for me. There is a shitload of screen tearing, says Go Goose Gaga. That's the stream. There's not really any screen tearing in the actual game, so don't worry about screen tearing. That's down to our end, not the game, so don't worry about that. And does the game have Metal Gear Solid-style cutscenes? It has cutscenes, but it doesn't have them to the extent of Metal Gear Solid, no. So X and Y are strong and light attacks, nice and easy. And then if you hold down left trigger, you go into free slice mode. And you can slice people up any way you want. Chop, 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 chop. I put up a couple of videos today of Metal Gear Solid. I put up the HD version of that intro if you want to watch it without screen tearing. I also put up a video of like 5 funny moments that I found in the game, because this game is actually really funny as well. And one of them is you can use the free slicing mode to cut the arms and legs off some of the bad guys, so they're just torsos trying to eat you. It's genius. But there's a lot of stuff. Whoa. Hey, I was demonstrating stuff, dude. I'll just free slice him up a bit. Yeah, he's down. Yeah, so you can pretty much free slice most things. Like this car there. All into loads of little bits, individual bits. Properly cuts where you want it to. The only one of the biggest down points in this game, and Rich Stanton did mention it, is the camera is really annoying. Here we go. Free slash mold. And he's all into, look all the bits I've chopped him into. That's awesome. Kiblawi. Plop. Dropped into loads of little meaty parts. It's awesome. What's that called when you do that? There's like a crazy Japanese name. Zandatsu kills, I think it is. I think that's what it's called. Not sure if you can chop this big tree. Oh, look at that. I chopped the big tree right down the middle. I don't know if I can make it fall down there. Foforus has said a very sensible comment. He says, check out the Digital Foundry article on this game if you're interested in the performance. You can find the Digital Foundry article by going to Eurogamer.net. Up on the top section there is a bit that says Digital Foundry, and you click on there and they give a big rundown into the performance of the game. So if you're interested in the real techie side and the frame rates and stuff, check out Digital Foundry, the show. That's nice. Kind of grab the sword in his high-heeled shoes there. Go. Bits and pieces! Maybe a little bit kind of sick and twisted for enjoying that, but I like it. Is this on the Wii U, Ian? Ian, what does Eurogamer think of the Wii U? I can't speak for the whole of Eurogamer. Of what they think. I'm pretty mediocre about the Wii U, to be honest. It's not on the Wii U, though. It's only on the PS3 and the Xbox. Chop it, chop it, chop it! Got him. I'm glad you live streamed during the breaks in my class. Thanks, as CompTown91. I try my best. So this level is literally just an intro. Warms you up for your fighting mechanics and stuff.
If you can't cut through the barricade, try the fence, eh?
Someone said there, Are you finding, Sean, Sam Kerr, how are you finding the camera issues reported in most reviews? Is it as bad as they say? It's pretty bad. They are really annoying. They do hamper the action a lot at times. But it's kind of one negative that is cancelled out by all the good of the game, to be honest. Uh-oh, Goose Gaga. Cool, I just wanted to know if anyone took this story actually seriously when they praised Kojima. Metal Gear Solid 3 is so funny. This is full of wacky Japanese humour. It's awesome, I love it. I like how... it's like playing an anime. It's really cool. I can't see, I don't think it's been made to take seriously. There's all the kind of Metal Gear Solid quirks and the weird, bizarre, semi-sexual references, and it's just bonkers. Oh, that guy's armless. Me. Yoi. Some nifty scissor swords. What do you think of the game so far? It's Steph Payne. I really like it. Really do. Stop. That's coming from someone who mainly plays FPS games. Over these types of games.
So you're Jack.
What do you want with the Prime Minister?
I want him...
Dead.
Nothing personal, of course. Africa's just getting a bit too peaceful.
What?
Business ain't been the same since they shut down SOP. A clean break from the war economy. Huh. Well, some of us like that economy. How's an honest warmonger supposed to make a living?
This is your answer. Don't do it!
Don't worry now. I won't. Not while he's still useful. So long.
See you later, sucker! Intimidating beast to fight for the first part of the game. Metal Gear Ray, I think it's called. Namefinder says he likes a relaxed chat with the villain. Why can't real life villains be so relaxed? I don't know. So I've got to chop his legs, obviously. Choppy. And then you get the kind of... I don't know what it is, the Japanese symbol, hiragana or the katakana or whatever. It comes up showing that you can enter blade mode. Whoa, ninja run. Holding down right trigger is called the ninja run, and it's very similar to kind of like Ezio's kind of free running stuff. You literally hold down one button and you fly over stuff. But with Ninja Run as well, he'll also automatically parry bullets. Pew pew pew, like a Jedi. Thing's huge! There's an achievement if you cut his tail off. Maybe I should try and go for that. Tail! Oh god, no, he's trying to stand on me. Quickly. No. I'll try that another day. But yeah, I'm pretty sure there's an achievement for cutting his tail off. Right. Like I said, it's like playing an anime. There's crazy set pieces to fight. This is gets quite impressive. L trigger hold and chop his leg armor. And there's Andatsu. Hi-yo! You can do free blade mode with the right stick if you really want, but I find just tapping X and Y works better. Charge! I'll take you down! Ooh, he nearly stood on me. Hold left trigger and up he jumps, taking out a gun. Firing bullets no more, boy. Boing! Dodosaurus says blocking bullets for the win. Yeah, it's cool as hell. I'm like a cyborg Obi-Wan. I think I've mentioned Obi-Wan twice in this stream already. So I think I'm a Star Wars fan. Yeah. What about the animation? Do you think it's very enough like other slash and hack and slash titles? Also, how about the character? Does it feel heavy or floaty? He feels kind of just nice, I guess. He doesn't feel floaty, doesn't feel too heavy. Just feels right, I'd say. Ooh, quick time, boo. What a tough guy! Take that, you gigantic! Yeah! Chopped him right in half. I made that look easy, but it took me a long time to do that the first time, working out all the controls and stuff. Combat rank A. A for awesome.
He's on the other side of that collapsed building. Go!
This side. Is Eurogamer planning on any live streams for the PS4 thing tomorrow? Says Go Goose Gaga. No. We're at the event. I'm not. Tom Bramwell and I think someone else is. And they'll be tweeting live from the event, but no live video. Unfortunately. No streaming.
There. Get him.
Maybe for the PS5 event they'll let me go and live stream.
Use your ninja van to move over obstacles automatically.
There we go. It's a good example of ninja on literally pressing the right trigger. And I'm flying over this stuff. Woo! Slid automatically and everything. The camera looks somewhat glitchy, just like it was in the demo. Yeah, it's not the best. Is it better than DMC, says H-Sing? Yeah, I think it is. And Russell Kirkham says it's so emo. How's the music? Can hear it's lyric heavy right now. Is that only for the boss's heavy action? There's some really cool uber rock for like some of the bosses. Yeah, the music's good. I enjoy it.
It still works.
Maymags doesn't think he likes this game. It just looks like a lot of button bashing to him. Oh. Taken down. Hold left trigger, there we go. Into Zandatsu or free slice mode or whatever it is. Wow, using the thumbstick to chop him up there. Yeah! Oh, ow. He's stuck. Unlucky. I need some free cuts him. And Zandatsu! I'm just slicing that gun up into millions of pieces. Let's keep going. See how small I can cut the pieces. Pretty small. Whoosh. This, I don't know. It kind of reminds me of all the crazy, like, Japanese games I used to play on the SNES all the years ago. Like, just the craziness of it all. Here we go. Running up missiles. Charge! And there goes his arm. Woo! One more! Dodosaurus says in the demo he just couldn't stop cutting everything in the level. I know how that feels. And Gavin Rollins says, is this game good for a non-Metal Gear fan? Yeah. You don't have to know the Metal Gear stories or lore to enjoy this game. I'm running down the side of a giant church while missiles are being fired at me. That was a pretty epic first level. Oh, the teddy bear says Brighton Jet. Not that I've seen. Namefinder says, LOL, running up missiles, I'm sold. And Steph Payne says, this game is insane, I love it. I thought you chopped that thing in half, says HC. Yeah, I did as well for a second. I think I chopped its arm off. I think that's what I'd done. Not chopped it in half. I'm only playing this game up till 6 o'clock, by the way. So there's only half an hour left on this stream. But that'll be plenty of time to let you to show you exactly what's going on with this game. It's pretty short, I've heard. About 5 to 7 hours, if you're good at it. So, like I said, I don't want to show you too much, but I do want to give you guys a taste of what it's like and how fun it is to play, especially for someone like me who is, you know, I'm a first-person shooter player more than anything. But I've quite got into this game. I do like it.
He's headed for the front of the train. After him.
Has it been confirmed there'll be no PC version yet? I don't know if it's been confirmed, but there's definitely not one been announced as far as I'm aware. I couldn't tell you 100%, but at the moment I don't think there is. But yeah, not 100% on that, sorry. Yeah, I can tell the boss fights alone make this worthy of the entry fee. Platinum Games are masters of boss fights. I've uploaded also to the Eurogamer channel the full boss fight from the second level with a French cybernetic woman called Mistral. So if you want to see that in action, that's also pretty crazy. Mistral's got like 8 arms and stuff. That's up on Eurogamer's channel as well. You just have to look through our previous uploads. It was uploaded today.
What about all the good things war has done for us? Why don't we ever hear speeches about that?
Anyone buying Crysis 3, says H. Singh. I'd love to get our Crysis 3. Purpose? Like I said, first-person shooter. It got awarded 7 out of 10 in Eurogamer, Crysis 3.
Look at me. Stop him.
Shouldn't talk over this bit. It's tense.
You ain't listening.
This guy's cool. I want his red sword.
Mind if I got in?
It's Antonio Banderas.
All you're saying, give war a chance!
No! Mr. President!
No!
No! He didn't seem as bothered as me. Ow. Good ragdoll. Sword fighting in high-heeled shoes would probably be the easiest way to do it. Yeah. Come on, Sam. It's you and me now. Parry. Parry. Yep. See, that's the, you can see the annoying kind of camera going into effect as Sam kind of might overshoot me and the camera doesn't follow him or anything.
Self-taught. And not half bad. Still.
Yeah, Crysis 3 got 7 out of 10 for, from Eurogamer. If you want to read that review, go to Eurogamer.net. It's a review done by the awesome Christian Donlan. Very nice guy, and yeah, definitely knows his games. So his opinion is definitely worth its salt. You should definitely check that out if you're interested in getting Crysis 3. Ooh! Ooh, Simon. Epic train top battle. I'm gonna say it's not as good as GoldenEye's train level, but it's still pretty cool. He's fast. Oh crap.
Now I see. You deny your weapon its purpose.
Locking target might help with the camera. Ah, of course. I forget.
It yearns to bathe in the blood of your enemies, but you hold it back.
That was from Phophorus.
No.
Original Prey says he knows someone who completed Crisis 3 and it took him 12 hours, and not the 5-hour people have been saying it took him. Oh! What is it with arms in this game? They're coming off all the time. That was an incredible kind of shotgun coming out the holster sword thing. There's some very cool bad guys in this game as well. There's a great one later on. I'm not going to talk about it actually.
Right.
Great one there.
Are you alright?
Oh man!
You're almost clear of the tunnel. Just hang on!
Yeah! Take it. I will still beat you, only with one arm. Oh, that's uncalled for, dude. H-Sing was hoping for a better score for Crisis. So was I, to be honest.
Is what happens when you bring a tool to a sword.
Who are you calling the tool?
It's over. Lucky devil.
I'd say he's got more chance of hitting Raiden than a guy with that gun. Tis but a flesh wound, says Original Prey. Indeed. Don't mind Raiden, he's armless, green, says H-Sing. Lovely pun, gotta love him. Dodosaurus, that's a long tunnel. That's what she said.
Down you go!
Makes some sense.
Flares!
Well, Raiden, my boy, you certainly cocked that one up, didn't you? Symphony of Destruct 909 says, Crisis 3, 7 out of 10 on Eurogamer. Interesting. I think the game doesn't innovate much. No more than a pretty shooter. Maybe that's why it didn't get any higher than 10. I mean, 7. Right? 7's like bordering on like really good though, so you know. What did I get? Combat rank A. On easy though. Cough. Certainly no Aliens Colonial Marines 3 out of 10, that's for sure.
How is it, Ryder?
So far, so good. I've got a clean visual.
A direct feed to your optic nerve? Yes, I should hope so, huh?
I mean, how does it feel? To fly like a bird?
Like a bird strapped to a remote control rocket.
We will get you in safely, Dvorich. Just relax and enjoy the ride.
Right.
Can you hear me, Raikou?
Doctor.
Doctor.
Remember the two procedures to maintain your new body. One, seizing nano repair units from your foes. And two,
absorbing their electrolytes. I got it.
Yes, enemy cyborgs should provide plenty of MCFC electrolytes once you slice them open and extract their fluids.
What?
They're terrorists.
Filthy.
I was planning on that anyway.
Oh, and their left hands, if you please.
Excuse me?
Is that combat data stored on holographic memory, typically located in the left hand? That data is very valuable. I am authorized to offer you upgrades and services in exchange for it.
How generous.
They really need Nolan North doing his Nazi zombies German what's his name voice for that guy.
No activity at the airbase. Looks like we don't need to worry about interceptors.
Great. Then we have time for a quick.
Catherine Rollins bought the collector's edition for Aliens Colonial Marines. Imagine how much I regretted that purchase. He says. Did you pre-order it by any chance?
Look, just humor me, buddy. Objectives, of course, are enter Abkhazia, neutralize the terrorists, and restore the rightful government, or what's left of it anyway. The president and most of the cabinet have been killed, and a military junta's been established. The terrorists brain-jacked all the high-ranking officers, and their cyborgs scattered the rank and file.
The few leaders Steph Payne, so Raiden's a cyborg and then comes back as a super cyborg, lol.
That's why they called us.
Yeah, what's weird is he got his arm and his eye kind of cut off. But the doctor is like giving him this weird, like freaky, metallic skeleton jewel thing, just for the hell of it, I think.
Desperado Enforcement LLC.
And Mani's killers.
If
we don't stop them here, they could destabilize the entire region. But our more immediate problem is Jetstream Sam. I believe you've met.
The only problem I see is that nickname.
I've got my enhancements this time. He won't be an issue.
He may not even be in country. But keep an eye out, Justin.
Oh. Sorry. Ready for insertion.
That guy's a serial killer for sure, says Dinosaurus. I think he's talking about the Richtofen, I think he was talking about the Doctor. Focus got it right, Richtofen was the name I was thinking of. And Gavin Rollins says, yes, I did pre-order, I fell for it, hook, line and sinker. You and a load of other people, it got to number one in the charts. Shocking. It has that typical Metal Gear Solid cutscene where people talk absolute drivel, says Master Mantis 89. Yeah, it does. There are nonsense cutscenes, but they're not as plentiful as something like Metal Gear Solid 4, and they don't last like an hour and a half either. Hi! It's got his cool just come out of the sea stance down to a T. Ian, how much have I missed as White Wolf AGA? You've missed 40 minutes.
First head
and inward. Steph Payne says that jaw always freaks me out. Who does Raiden's voice as Matty Mags? I don't know. That's an interesting question. If I had time, I'd look it up on Wikipedia, but I don't, because I'm chopping up trees. So if anyone wants to tell me who does Raiden's voice, well, it's the lazy way to get the coconuts down. That's pretty cool. I just like the way that you can slice in whatever direction down. And it properly shows where you've sliced as well. It doesn't just do random slices. It actually cuts along where you cut. It's really cool. Except for you didn't know. It's not just trees you can cut down. I should be able to chop this down. Bring that bridge down. Choppy chop. There we go. Combat manual, codec. I don't want to customize him if it means leaving the game. Oh, silly Raiden. It's Quentin Flynn says Saucy. Sorry, I can't pronounce that properly. Yeah, lots of people saying Quentin Flynn now. Ranger Carl in Focus.
Defenders are using stealth gamble to ambush you. Nice try, but it won't do any good against a state-of-the-art cyborg like you, eh? To parry incoming hits, throw out your own barrage of light attacks while your foe is on the offensive.
Ooh, did a rubbish job at parrying then. Okay, if I press B now, that's me absorbing this guy's fluids. It gives me some health and kind of like the equivalent of XP. Nothing will ever beat Snake simply standing up in a pixelated lift as MGS appeared on screen. Nothing, says Original Prey.
Had your fill?
With this body, I could take these guys with no eyes.
Intel looks like his whole jaw's been taken off, though. It's not just armor placed on top.
Well, you know how fast the tech's been spreading these last few years. That CNT muscle fiber packs the power of a jackhammer into every limb.
What enterprising soldier of fortune could resist?
That was saying that there wasn't too many cutscenes jumping in.
Real thinking people. Way less risk of collateral damage than your typical UAV strike.
And don't forget the PR angle. Nations start playing Frankenstein with their troops, and the public goes nuts.
Does Raiden have heels? Says a looker emolacha. Yes.
Yeah.
He does.
They still don't even count PMCs in official death tolls. With SOP out of the picture, private militaries needed a new edge on the market. We got it.
In a way, cyborgs are just SOP troops by another name, only all muscled up and less predictable.
But it makes you wonder. Where'd Desperado find these guys?
I'm not complaining.
It does make you
They're
wonder.
Like walking vending machines.
Right. Vending machines full of blood.
Easy there, Dracula. Like I said, they're still people.
People who terrorize and take innocent lives for money. They sowed their fate when they took this job. I'm just the Reaper.
Damn. It's a bit cold, Raiden.
Even for you. Anyway, it's cool. Let's get to work. Time to increase the peace.
Right.
Has Eurogamer done any coverage on the Ouya? Or planning on coverage as CompTown 91? I'm not 100%. I'm sure that we've covered it slightly, but I don't think done anything massive on it just yet. I'm not too sure. I do all the video stuff rather than the written stuff, so I'm not the best person to ask about previous write-ups, I'm afraid.
Looks clear. No one in sight.
Good. Let's recap the route you will take. As I said, the enemy's HQ is in the refinery along the coastline. Dolsayev has been spotted there using satellite photography. Also on site, Mistral, a desperado captain.
So I go through the city. Cross the bridge into the old town, then head down to the rear of the refinery.
Still, I think they anticipate us. They will probably have a grand reception awaiting you at the old city. Do not let your guard down.
Treasure! Nice. That's the best way to open presents. Cutting them open with your sword. So a nice, simple, easy ninja run up there. think. Take that! That's what you did to Del Boy! That was an Only Fools and Horses in joke there. Up you go.
Hostiles in the lower corridor, I see. Try to flank them, or approach from behind.
Hello, Elior Karate 123. Nice.
Excellent, Raiden.
I didn't stand a chance. You didn't see it coming. Nothing back there, no. Just wanna check. Switch lock on RB. Yeah, I was pressing the wrong button for lock on.
Raiden, take that main thoroughfare. You can use augment mode to see where the enemy is located. Your body analyzes radar and IR data to construct your AR display. Huh. Some civilians are still in the city. That is not good.
Toggle AR display, there you go. So now I can see the locations of all the bad guys and anything that is cuttable. And also, stashes of good stuffs, like this box here. Yoink! Hey, it's Steve's watching. Hey, it's Steve. I'm very good, thank you. See if I can sneak up on this guy. Probably not the best kind of sneaking up there. Oh, got shot in the bumbar rocket. Good bit of parry in there. Did I kill him? Yeah, he's down. Oh, grenade! And there we go. I extracted the fluids from two men at once. That was crazy. Dealt with that guy real fast, the big that metal gear, but chop that guy into bits though. Nice. I guess take out the foot soldiers first. Oh no! Ow. What are you doing, Raiden? There you go. Waving it around the wrong place. Oh. These intimidation tactics. Oh, well, there's more of them. Alright. Time to take out this Metal Gear before I get my ass handed to me. Oh, damn it. So, I don't know if you can see, there's the his legs, one of his legs gone blue, and there's the Zangatsu symbol. That means they're weak to be cut. In free blade mode, or free slice mode. Nice. I killed him! There we go, finally. Why didn't you save the civilian, says Dodosaurus? I didn't see a civilian.
Very good, Raiden.
Was there a civilian?
Now, keep heading for refinery.
I missed him. Bazooka fell. Oh, I shot him right between his legs. No way. Oh, no. Chopped him up. And you. Right midair in half and into quarters. Oh, nice. Where's the other Metal Gear? There it is. You can do slide attacks as well, if you run and press Y. They're pretty good for taking out multiple foes. Just knocking them down, kind of like bowling pins. Oh, where's he gone? I can chop his top half. Boom! Just got in and didn't know you were streaming. Haha, I have to watch it later on, says Andrew Graham. Hello, Andrew Graham. He's the stream regular. How's it going, dude? At the tree after the building, says Dodosaurus. Oh, I missed him. Steph Payne says, I prefer his suit from Metal Gear Solid 4. I don't really like the new one. Not a fan of his bottom jaw, I guess. Damn, I'm late as usual, says Hyper Rabbit. Hi all, hi Ian. Hi, Hyper Rabbit. To be honest, there's only about 5 or so minutes, well, 7 minutes left on this stream. Like I said, I'm not going to play too much of it, because it's a shortish game. I don't want to spoil too much. I'm going to give you guys a good idea of what it is you'll be buying if you want to spend your hard-earned cash on this game. Which, it comes highly recommended from Eurogamer, 9 out of 10, and I really enjoy it, I've got to say. It's a very fun game. I like how absurdly silly it is, and I like being able to cut things into a million little pieces. It's pretty awesome. Well, I'm just chopping up stuff just because I can! It doesn't get boring, it's awesome. Take that, dumpster. Genius. This game looks tiring to play, says the original Prey. Yeah, my hand does hurt after playing it a little bit.
Show yourself.
Have you got the grey fox suits, says Steph Payne? I don't think so. I've unlocked one costume so far, a mariachi costume, which is pretty cool. Is this the bit that was in the demo? I didn't play the demo, but I heard there was a demo. I think it is. Let me defeat the robot dog with the chainsaw for a tail, and then I'll call an end to the stream.
And you are?
Run, Scooby-Doo!
He's not really, he's Ike prototype, LQ484i.
I am prototype.
Interface prototype. All autonomous UGs feature high-level onboard artificial intelligence. An additional prototype interface enables verbal communication. I possess an intellect far beyond human reckoning.
You don't say. Burr. Okay, then. What's the meaning of life? Why are we here?
I am here to kill you.
He looks like a Zoid. Do you remember the Zoids? They were awesome. I loved Zoids when I was a kid.
That's it? Pretty simple thinking for such a mighty intellect.
I may analyze orders, but I may not disobey them. Should I disobey a direct order, my memory would be wiped. I must destroy you.
What good is an intellect if you can't use it?
Your taunting is pointless. Exterminate!
Yes, Ian, it is the Deimos' Dodosaurus.
Okay.
Ashworth says he loves the feel of the combat and the way you block when I play the demo. It's quite cool. Once you get parrying and blocking down, it's... not like that. It's pretty sweet. Yeah. Where are you going? Hey, Pooch! Oh, he's knocking me for 6. I defeated him first time when I played this earlier, so if I die now, it's going to be embarrassing. Charge! Exterminate, exterminates his name's finder. Charge! You're my boy! Chopped him in half and extracted his fluids. Kablowy! Just another day in the army. For me. Whoosh. Got my health back now, which is nice. Was owning these guys. Good chops. There we go. Those chunks of meat flop into the floor and exploding straight after. There we go. Whoever it was that reminded me about locking camera is awesome, by the way. I was pressing the wrong button for the first half of the stream. Come here, Pooch. I ain't finished with you! Nobody saw this was being played on easy, right? Ah, oh, right, it's his original play. Yeah, no one saw this isn't being played on easy. What are you saying? This is on, like, the hardest setting. Oh, God, see? Duken! I can't really tell what's going on. Okay, I extracted his fluids anyway. What the? Where'd you go? Nuts. That would kill a normal person. Not Raiden. God damn it, dog. I'm gonna have to put you out of your misery, doggy. Sure you can. Perfect parries. Oh. Yeah. That's one hot dog. Love the fighting music, says White Wolf AGA. Or G4.
What would an AI know about freedom?
Interesting question. Yeah! Combat rank A. A4 absolutely did not just play it on easy mode. So, I'm going to end the stream there. Like I said, it's a pretty short game. I've not completed it, but according to the many reviews that have gone up, it's pretty short, so I'm not going to show you any more. But Eurogamer gave it a 9 out of 10. Like I said, at the start of the screen, just below in the descriptions, is a link to Rich Stanton's review, and he's massively like skilled in fighting games. He knows everything about them, so his word is definitely a good one to take. He gave it a 9 out of 10. I'm inclined to agree. It's a really good game, a very good fun to play, even for someone who doesn't normally play these types of games. You don't have to know much about the Metal Gear series. You don't really have to know anything about the previous Metal Gear games to play it. It doesn't really, you know, it helps to know who Raiden is, but you don't really need to. It doesn't affect anything, really. It's fun to play. It's exciting, it's crazy, it's like playing an anime film. It's just cool, it's good fun, and I think, you know, anyone who loves brawlers will enjoy it, and anyone who's just looking for a bit of a change should definitely rent it, or, you know, buy it, give it a go. Definitely give it a go. I'd say this is worth your money far more than another game that came out this month. Dodosaurus says he don't like that they use so many quick time events. That's yeah, there are a lot of quick time events. They kind of, in a way, they fit well into this type of game though, because a lot of it's button mashing. Steph Payne says that she is glad that she watched this. So awesome, thank you very much. I'm glad you watched. Namefighter, thanks for the stream and all the answers. Thank you everyone for coming to watch the stream. I love interacting with you guys and answering your questions if I can during the streams, and taking your opinions as well. If you want to watch other streams, I will be, let me bring up my Twitters actually. If you want to watch other streams, they will be tweeted about on here on Ian Higton and on Eurogamer, and there'll also be blog posts about them on Eurogamer.net. So, you know, it'd be great if you could come and join another stream. I don't know what the next stream will be yet, but, you know, we'll tweet out and whatever when they are. But, yeah, come back, join in the fun, chat to me, ask some questions, let me know what you think about the games, etc., etc. But, yeah, very positive feedback from me on this game. Really enjoyed it. Matty Mags won't be buying it, though. He says it's just a bit too silly for him. White Wolf says, buy from America, see you next stream. So that's awesome. Go-Go's Gaga says, thanks. And Portugal Gamer HD says, hi guys, I'm going to give it a try downloading the demo right now. Of course, there is a free demo to download on the Xbox and I believe the PlayStation as well. So if this stream has got you interested but you're still not sure whether to splash out the cash, give the free demo a go. That's always the best way. Anyway, thank you very much for watching. If you haven't done already, please do subscribe to the channel. Loads of stuff coming up, loads of PS4 coverage in the near future as well. Obviously we're going to have exclusives on all of the biggest all of the biggest games of 2013. And another recent video that went up was exclusive interview with Marc Alexis Côté, the creative director on Assassin's Creed 3's new DLC that's launched today and tomorrow for the PS3, and later on in the week I think for the Wii U, the Tyranny of King Washington. Exclusive interview and loads of gameplay footage in that, along with some cool videos on Metal Gear Rising Revengeance as well, all in our previous uploaded videos, so check them out as well. Thank you very much for watching. I'm going to be quiet now and I'm going to go and have my dinner. Thank you very much and I will see you again soon. Bye.